Hi, you guys. Long time no see. I'm finally back. I was sick for a couple of weeks, and you can probably still hear it, but I'm just dying to get back. I really missed it. And I'm going to switch things up a little today. I'm using my phone to record along with a lapel mic. I think you guys should be able to hear me a little bit better now. Obviously, feel free to comment on the quality of the video, but I want you guys to be happy with the quality. But anyway, I'm so excited for what we're going to make today. It is Christmas themed. Specifically, it is a part of my South Florida heritage. It is coquito. And if you haven't had coquito, I think it's so much more delicious than your typical eggnog. And it is spiked with rum, and it has a very light coconut taste. It is egg-free. So if you're allergic to eggs, the traditional way to make coquito is without eggs. At least that's what all the Puerto Ricans in my family did. So I like to make it without eggs as well. So it's very simple. It's going to be a little bit different than your traditional coquito because we are making keto coquito. And I guarantee you, you will not be able to tell the difference. It is just as good, if not better, than its sugary, fat-laden counterpart. This one's got some fat in it too, but it's good fats. And basically, all you're going to need is rum of your choice. Don't judge. I got Captain Morgan, but the standard rum that is typically used is Bacardi Superior, but this is what I had on hand. I strongly encourage you using a white rum. However, you can use a spiced rum as well. Just keep in mind, we're going to be adding spices too. And speaking of spices, you're going to want cinnamon and nutmeg. You are going to need some vanilla extract. And to make our condensed milk to put into this coquito, we have to make it from scratch because we don't want all the sugar and carbs. So you're gonna need butter, heavy whipping cream, and that vanilla extract's gonna go in it as well. And then you're also going to want a sugar alternative. I have here brown sugar alternative, but you can use regular white granular sugar alternative. You can use a powdered version. I like the brown sugar alternative because it lends kind of like a caramelized flavor to it that I really like, and it makes it taste really authentic. And the next thing you're gonna want is a can of coconut cream, the cream, unsweetened. Make sure it'll say unsweetened on there. And then the next thing you're going to want is coconut milk. I grabbed 2 cans. I think you're going to need roughly 1.5 cans. You're also going to want to bust out your blender or a food processor, because after we're done making the condensed milk alternative, we're all simply just going to be blending it all together. And that's it. Easy peasy. Let's get started. All right, you guys, we are going to be working on our condensed milk. Going to be very, very easy. Get a pan, medium size, large, small, it doesn't matter. We're not making very much. It's roughly 1 cup, but we're going to add our 1.5 tablespoons of butter. I'm going to melt this first just so it it mixes well with the cream and the sugar and everything. Once this gets melted down pretty well, I'm going to add the cream. So this is going to be a pretty simple process. So after I'm done adding everything, basically all we're going to do is stir it for 15 to 20 minutes. It just depends on how strong your flame is. I got this new stove I saved up for a very long time, and the flame on it is so strong. I'm not used to it. So I've been burning my breakfast every morning, still getting used to the flame. But anyway, once you're done adding, that was 1 cup of heavy whipping cream, 1.5 tablespoons of butter. We are now going to add 1/4 cup of our sugar alternative. And it doesn't have to be packed. Okay. Again, use the sugar alternative you have on hand. I'm all about that. It's going to be all melted together anyway. Again, I just like the brown sugar alternative because you get a nice kind of caramelized flavor that I think is very authentic to traditional condensed milk. I've had a lot of condensed milk desserts in my life, growing up in South Florida and also with a Southern grandmother, banana pudding, and I believe it's in tres leche as well. Pretty much any of the delicious heavy desserts. Now that we've incorporated the sugar, what we're going to do is just do 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. And I'm pretty sure that's roughly about all I have left is 1 teaspoon. Ooh, maybe not even. So I have about a half a teaspoon left, so I'm just going to use that. But you do need to use roughly 1 teaspoon. You can also do like, if you're out of vanilla, you could use almond. I have almond extract that I could use in there as well. So I'm just going to keep stirring this. It smells so good already. And basically, like I said, 15, 20, maybe 25 minutes, you're just stirring until it thickens up. It looks syrupy, just like traditional condensed milk. So I'm going to keep stirring. You want to keep your eye on it. You don't want it to stick or burn to your pan. And then I will be back. So it has been roughly 20 minutes, and this is what your mixture should look like. Very syrupy. And it's going to get a little thicker as it cools, and it should be the perfect consistency. And you're going to want to wait until it cools anyway. So I will meet you back here in roughly half an hour. Okay, here is the finished product. Look at how syrupy that is. It's all condensed down, hence the name. And it is, oh my gosh, you have to taste it. It just tastes so good. So the next step is really just blending everything together. So we'll take this and we'll put it in our blender along with the other ingredients, and we will be all done. So I got a little ahead of myself here, and I just went ahead and I put the 2 cups of coconut milk in here. The can is just under 2 cups. It's like 1 3/4. So what I did, instead of opening another can of coconut milk and only using a little bit of it, I hate doing that. So what I did was I just put a quarter cup of the heavy cream that we already had. And so we have 2 cups of that total, and then we need 1 cup of coconut cream. When you first open a can of coconut cream, it's super thick and heavy on the top. But what you're going to want to do is mix it up a little bit with a spoon before adding a cup, because there is also liquid on the bottom. So it's not going to be nice and silky and smooth the way coconut milk is. The cream is going to be like solid on top. But make sure you mix it up because there is some liquid at the bottom. So we're going to measure out 1 cup of the coconut cream. And it's about half a can. And then we're going to put that in there. My blender is getting a little full. And it's really not a big deal. If your blender is getting a little full, just blend it. You can take some out and then add some more to blend it. No worries if you don't have like a huge container for blending. I do this all the time where I'll fill it up halfway with my ingredients, and then I'll move the blended ingredients to like a bowl or a cup or something, and then I'll reblend everything together in small batches basically. Okay. So it's a little too full. I'll show you the max line. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take some of that out. No big deal. And then I'm going to add the cinnamon and nutmeg. I'm all out of vanilla extract, but you want to add vanilla extract as well. What I'm going to do is just supplement almond extract, which I'm obsessed with almond flavor. It's not really going to have that big of an impact, so don't worry. So we need to add a half teaspoon of cinnamon, a quarter teaspoon of nutmeg, and then 1 teaspoon of vanilla or whatever extract you have on hand. It's really not a big deal. So let's do a quarter teaspoon of the almond extract. And then I have my cinnamon here and my nutmeg. All right, let's blend this bad boy together. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is, since it was so full and I didn't have enough room to blend it with the condensed milk, I'm now going to remove this batch, put in the rest of our coconut cream along with the condensed milk, and blend that together. So we want to take all of our condensed milk. I'm going to move it into like a flexible measuring cup. You can put it in a pitcher, anything that makes it easier to add to the blender along with your other ingredients. So after, just to summarize what I'm doing here, since I don't have a huge blender container enough for all the ingredients, I'm adding the condensed milk to the leftover cream, blending that, and then I'm gonna take the first batch we blended that had all the cinnamon and nutmeg, and then I'm gonna blend it all together just separately, like in a bowl. It's not a big deal. It's really smooth, so you'll be able to blend it very easily with like a whisk. No problem at all. That's it. I'll meet you back here with it all blended up. Okay, you guys, are you ready to mix the final product? The easiest way to do this, if you did what I did and you blended everything in a container that was a little too small, get a pitcher or a big bowl. The pitcher is obviously going to be a little bit easier. And I've got the two separate mixtures here, and I'm just going to mix them together. It's so nice and thick, and it smells really, really good too. So we're mixing those two together. And then what we're going to do, just make sure it's mixed up really well. It smells like Christmas. It smells absolutely amazing. Now you could stop here, and if you stop here, it's going to be extremely thick. I'm talking heavier than heavy cream. But what you're supposed to do is add the rum at this point. We are going to add roughly 1 to 2 cups. I like to taste it. Start with a half a cup and keep adding until it's kind of at the level of alcohol that you want it to be at. The Coquito that I grew up with was pretty strong, but typically, we would put it like in our coffee or just have a really small glass of it. It's not something you're gonna just be chugging. So start with a half a cup. I'm actually gonna go just start with 1 cup because I know that I at least like 1 cup of rum in it. And then we'll taste it and then we'll go from there. Okay, so add it to your pitcher. And you're gonna stir it up really, really well. The rum is so complimentary to this because it's sweet. And it's actually pretty undetectable, at least in my opinion. But just make sure it's mixed up really well. And then actually, I think I'm gonna get a small, like, espresso cup just to taste it, to see if it's at the level that I like it at. Really get in there. It's already a much better consistency after adding the 1 cup of rum. It's thinned out quite a bit. Okay, so I've got my little espresso cup, and I'm going to try some and see if it's strong enough. I mean, that's pretty strong already, but it does need a little bit more. So I think I'm just going to add maybe a quarter cup more and then go from there. Keep in mind, it's supposed to be pretty boozy. Actually, is that half a cup? That should be good. It really just needed a little topper, if you will. And then when you're trying it, keep in mind it's going to taste, in my opinion, it's going to taste way better once it's chilled. Okay. This actually looks like the perfect consistency. I'll show you what it looks like so you know from looking at it that you've added or you've mixed everything sufficiently and added the appropriate amount of rum. So good. It's, to me, it's much lighter. If you are not an eggnog fan, do not be afraid of Coquito. It has a completely different taste, mainly because it's missing the eggs, but it doesn't have that overly heavy flavor that traditional eggnog has. Granted, even though this has condensed milk in it and coconut cream, it's still so much lighter in flavor. Ooh, it's strong, but it's a good strong. It's perfect. I typically like a little more cinnamon than the average person does, but what I'll do instead of adding it to the batch, because I like to make this for family and friends, instead of adding it to the batch, I add a little bit of cinnamon over the top, like after I pour it. So, this is really good. It's a little too early to be drinking this. It's noon. I had to film, you know, with it being light outside, but it is so good. It is Christmas in a cup. You guys have to make this. You saw how easy it was. The hardest part was making that condensed milk, and then everything else is just blending it. And if you have a large food processor, that whole song and dance I did with the blender that was too small, that goes by the wayside, and it turns out so much easier than doing this. But what you're going to want to do when you are done with this is you're going to want to bottle it up in something that's well sealed. This pitcher, even with the lid on, it's not going to be sealed well enough. You want to have something like this. This is actually an empty vodka bottle. I'm sure they sell bottles like this at maybe like Walmart or even Michael's, but this was a vodka bottle, and you can see how it snaps on there, and it's got a really tight fit. And this should stay fresh in your refrigerator in a bottle like this for roughly a week. So I hope you guys make this. Again, I think you're going to love it. If you do make it, let me know in the comments how you liked it. And I will also put the nutrition facts so you know how many carbs are in a serving, how many calories, and how much fat too. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. It was nice seeing you guys again, and I will be back. Thank you so much. Have a great day, you guys.